Between the innocence of babyhood and the dignity of manhood, we find a delightful creature called a scout. Scouts come in assorted sizes, shapes, weights, and colors. But all scouts have the same creed. On my honor, I will do my best to make every scout meeting as noisy and as exciting and as much fun as possible. To do my duty, to harass the scoutmaster and the troop committeemen, and to obey them as little as possible. To help other people have as much fun on hikes, campouts, swimming parties, ball games, and outings as I do. To keep myself mentally awake by matching wits with the forest ranger, by outthinking the lifeguard, by frustrating the school teacher, and mystifying my parents. And morally straight by shocking everyone by sitting reverently in church. That's not quite how the official one reads, but it is much more interesting and certainly more fun. Scouts are found everywhere, on top of, underneath, inside of, climbing on, swinging from, running around, or jumping to. A scout is a composite. He has the energy of a bull moose, the agility of a swallow, the alertness of a night owl, the lungs of a bullfrog, the endurance of a tortoise, the appetite of a horse, the audacity of a magpie, the voice of a screech owl, and the heart of a dove. A scout is a magical creature which denies accurate description or understanding, but without which our future would be in doubt, and without which there would be an empty void in the hearts of many parents and scoutmasters. Even more unique and special than this is a small species within this group, curiously called the eagle. An order of young men who find themselves conspicuously between boyhood and manhood, knowing, understanding, and living the moral code of honor of adulthood, and yet still firmly grasping the vitality and exuberance of youth. This group is a seldom found minority in the race of man, who has not yet been dimmed by the disillusionment and discouragement of maturity, who has not been tainted or tempted by the corrupt rewards of a rancid world. Here is an order of young men who hold not only the hope and optimism of youth, but also the ability and talent of the old. Not only the innocence of boyhood, but the strength and power of manhood. Not only the firmness and wisdom of the ages, but also the humor and fun-loving spirit of the young. Here then is truly a unique and special order, the Order of the Eagle Scout. We welcome tonight to this select fraternity Eagle Scout candidates Matt Warner, Cliff Bunot, and Cody Rich. It has been a few years since you first entered the troop. Your mother taught you so young, about 11, was the perfect age to join with the other boys in your scouting career. As you became a member of the troop, you memorized the scout oath and law, its principles and symbols. You learned the care and importance of your nation's flag and mastered certain basic tying techniques. You became a tenderfoot scout. You immediately went on to learn the skills of the second class scout. You studied the art and techniques of hiking and outdoor activities. You took a hike. You learned to master compass and to orient a map. To prepare you for emergency and living in the wilderness, you learned various plants and animals, the correct and safe uses of a knife and axe. You learned to cook a full course meal without utensils, over an open fire using only two matches. And you were not allowed to forget your duties learned under your tenderfoot, testing as you continue to render your good turns and live by the scouting principles. As you gained your first class rank, you were singled out from the other boys as the testing and trails became more rigorous. You mastered the techniques of outdoor camping as you carefully planned, organized, and executed two 24-hour campouts, including food, shelter, and cleanup. You learn safe swimming practices, including a 50-yard swim, advanced first aid, knot tying, lashing, and service hours. Soon you found yourself at the halfway mark on the way to Eagle Scout, and yet the hardest tasks were still ahead of you. To obtain star rank, you earned 6 merit badges, which meant in-depth study, training, and performance in selected fields. In each of these subjects, you had to master certain advanced techniques and ideas, but you were also held accountable for a service project, as well as serving as an officer in the scouting program. Next came the rank of Life Scout, and with its stiffer and more difficult requirements, you earned 5 additional merit badges and a service project, filling a job in the troop as an officer and passing the customary border review. Now came the final and most difficult effort in achieving the rank of Eagle. A total of 21 merit badges were mastered and passed, as well as planning, developing, and carrying out a service project, filling the top leadership position in the troop, and passing a final board of review before a district representative. Now let us find out what happens to these Eagle Scouts. For every 100 boys who join scouting, records indicate that rarely will one be brought before the juvenile court system. 2 will become Eagle Scouts. In the LDS Church, about 5%. 17 will become future scouting volunteers. 12 will have their first contact with the church through scouting. 1 will enter the clergy. 5 will earn their church's religious award. 18 will develop a hobby that will last through his adult life. 18 will develop a hobby that will last through his adult life. 8 will enter a vocation that was learned through the merit badge program. 1 will use his scouting skill to save his own life. 1 will use his scouting skill to save the life of another person. Tonight we honor 3 more Boy Scouts in 300. We know the things that have been done in the past. Imagine what they will do in the future.
like to welcome you all out tonight. We're about ready to go. They had a few pictures to take in there, and they're all ready to go. This Eagle Court of Honor is for Matthew Warner and Cliff Bunot and Cody Rich. They let you know who I am. My name's Dwayne Kelso. I used to be in the ward. I used to be one of their scout leaders at one point in time. And I guess that's why they asked me to be over this tonight. I told Doug, I said, I don't know why we, because we're leaders, we end up being up here. But I think I figured it out, Doug. He'll be up here in a while. It'll be his turn. When these boys are in scouts, we ask them to do a lot of things that I'm sure they don't want to do. And they're growing lessons. And we always thought we were the ones that was growing them, but I guess at one point in time they get turned around on us, and we get to do that growing lesson too. So anyway, I'll get on with it. We'll start out with the presentation of the colors. And we got Johnny Baker's gonna be calling the colors tonight. And after we get through with that, we'll have the invocation given by Vern Warner. And then we'll go to that point, and then I'll come back up. Okay.
Color guard attention. The audience, please rise. Color guard present colors. The audience, please repeat the Pledge of Allegiance after me.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Two. Color guard, post color guard. Color guard, dismiss.
Our Father in heaven, as we gather together this night with friends and neighbors and people that have come from far away and been able to come and present things to Matthew, Cody, and Cliff, we're indeed grateful for the efforts, for the sacrifices they've made. We're indeed grateful for these three young men that they've been able to go through the scouting program to realize the goal that can be had by, and that of reaching an Eagle and becoming an Eagle Scout. We're grateful for the leaders that have given their time and their talents to these boys, and for the great effort and time spent away from their families for the benefit of them. We ask that thy blessings will be upon this court of honor, that thy spirit will be here, and the messages that will need to be presented, and the awarding of the badge and the Eagle Oath might be something that these boys will remember, that they'll remember this great responsibility as they accept that of an Eagle, that they will need to be an example to the younger scouts in their troops, and to those people they come in contact with the rest of their lives. We ask to bless them that they might realize the great opportunity and the great blessings they've been given, and now the great responsibility which they carry. We're again grateful for all those that have come here tonight. We pray that they might enjoy and realize and be able to be comforted and know that this was a great opportunity to be here tonight. We're again thankful for them. Again, we ask for thy spirit to be with us now, and turn the meeting unto thee, and these things we say in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
All right, next thing that they have on the program is a live eagle presentation, and Colleen Mannix from Tracy Aviary is the one that will be presenting that, and we'll go ahead and do that part right now.
Everybody can hear me because I won't be able to use the mic because of her, but I'll talk loud. Hi, my name is Colleen, and this is Nejoni. Her name comes from the Navajo word Nehuni, which means beautiful. I think that suits her well. She is a golden eagle here with me tonight to honor Eagle Scouts. To accept the name Eagle is not to be taken lightly. As I hope you will see, there is much to the simple name. On July 4, 1776, a committee was formed to determine our national symbol. Benjamin Franklin felt no bird portrayed freedom like the wild turkey. And if others had agreed, I'd be talking to a turkey scout this evening with a much heavier bird on my arm. But John Adams and Thomas Jefferson looked to the eagle and shared with others what they saw in this bird. They saw courage, nobility, loyalty, honor, and beauty. Anyone who sees an eagle up close or soaring high in the sky can see what Jefferson and Adams had in mind. In 1782, the bald eagle was not only our national bird, but our national symbol. An Eagle Scout who shares these same qualities is worthy of our nation's symbol and able to represent our country. Symbols are important, but there's much more to the eagle than what we see. For example, they have many strengths of their own. They can see 10 times as far as we can, which means if we were to place a newspaper on the ground, an eagle soaring 150 feet in the sky could read the finest print. If he could read English, of course. An Eagle Scout who sets his sights on lofty goals shows that he too shares the vision of the eagle. Eagles have strong talons. If I could have everybody squeeze their hands as tight as they can. Most of us have a grip of about 40 pounds of pressure. Her grip is 50 times as strong as ours, about 2,000 pounds of pressure. It is equal to the crushing weight of a car. Eagles also have 7-foot wingspans, which are used for soaring high in the sky and diving at prey at speeds exceeding 100 miles an hour. The eagle is quick and adept at catching prey. While they are powerful hunters, they use these powers wisely. They only kill when absolutely necessary. This is why I have no reason to fear Nejoni. She will not harm me as long as I treat her with respect. An Eagle Scout who uses his strengths and powers wisely will also be respected. An eagle is devoted to family. By knowing what plants make good nesting materials, the eagle builds a sturdy home. Both the male and the female return to the nest each year to raise a family. They are gentle and nurturing, and the young soon learn to respect them. An Eagle Scout has shown this devotion to family and his respect for elders. With all these strengths and devotions, the eagles are a truly magnificent creature, but they do not arrive this way from birth. When they hatch, they have no flight feathers, poor vision and little strength, but they grow feathers and learn to fly. At about 2 months, they take short flights from the nest, never straying too far from home. Eventually, they learn to hunt on their own and take off to live free and raise their own families. Get her a little adjusted here. She's like poking my arm. An Eagle Scout follows a similar path. First, he too is completely dependent upon his parents. But with growth, learning, trial and error, he gains skill and knowledge. He first learns to serve others and then becomes a leader himself. There is no better teacher than time. And as a scout matures, he learns many valuable lessons. I would like to share with you some of the lessons man has learned about the eagle. Between 1940 and 1963, 20,000 golden eagles were shot and killed in the United States alone. They were shot because ranchers thought they were killing their valuable livestock when in fact they were acting as scavengers and eating animals that had already died. They were also helping farmers by eating animals they often think as pests, such as rabbits. It was ignorance alone that resulted in this many deaths. Najoni herself fell victim to this ignorance. She was shot in her right wing. She is no longer able to extend far enough to be able to fly well. Unable to hunt in the wild, she now has a home at the Tracy Aviary. In 1972, the Endangered Species Act was passed, granting full federal protection to all birds of prey. While this has helped many birds, including the bald eagle, whose numbers are increasing, the golden eagle numbers are still decreasing. This is due to human overpopulation and destruction of the sagebrush desert, making food and nesting sites increasingly hard to find. If we lose the golden eagle, we lose them forever, with only birds like the Jody to remind us of our mistakes. As an Eagle Scout, you share in the responsibility we all have to preserve the wilderness, protect the environment, and respect every living creature. At this point, I'd be happy to answer any questions you have about Najoni or eagles in general. Any questions?
How heavy is he?
12 pounds. She gets heavier as the minute goes. That's why the hands up So.
Is it true that the golden eagle is a larger bird than the bald eagle?
Yeah, they're pretty close to the same size, but they are a little bit bigger. It depends on their weight, because some birds can weigh more than the others. So she's actually a pretty light bird compared to others.
What's their lifespan?
She can live up to about 40 to 50 years in captivity, and about half of that in the wild.
Can you show us her wingspan?
Yep, I sure can. If she doesn't, now she's black. She doesn't hold it out very long. Are there any other questions?
How do you tell the difference between a bald eagle and a golden eagle?
Golden eagle has this gold, see the gold feathers around the back of her neck? That's how you tell. Bald eagles look a lot like golden eagles when they're immature, when they're young. And then, of course, bald eagles have the white head when they're adults. Any other questions?
What kind of foods does she like to eat?
We feed her rats and mice and a mixture of meat. They're dead. We don't put live ones in, but she might catch some live ones on her own, though. So, are there any other questions?
Can you do that one more time?
Sure. Okay. Is this in the way? Did you get it? Okay. Are there any other questions? Okay, I'll go ahead and wrap things up. I hope you all come to a better understanding of the name Eagle and all that it encompasses. To achieve the name Eagle is a great honor, but with it comes the expectation that you will continue to live by its values and virtues for the rest of your life. On behalf of the Tracy Aviary, I congratulate all of you and wish all of you a good evening. Thank you for your time.
All right, now we'll have Joel Fredrickson, and then after Joel Fredrickson, we'll have Doug Bunot as a speaker, and then we'll have Eagle Ceremony video that'll be done by Heidi Wilright.
Tonight we're here to honor and add three more names to the list of fellow Eagle Scouts and to place these names on the Eagle plaques of Troops 474 and Troop 315. These new Eagle Scouts will join the list of fine young men from these troops who have achieved this distinction. To earn the highest rank in scouting, a young man has to spend a great deal of time, effort, and energy. Therefore, we recognize their accomplishments with a special program on this occasion. Scouting is one of the greatest organizations in the world to foster the highest ideals in citizenship. It is little wonder that so many of our nation's greatest leaders have some of their earliest leadership experiences in scouting. Scouting remains constant and unchanged in a changing world. In the total development from boyhood to manhood depend upon the physical, mental, and moral growth expressed in the Scout Oath. The skills, challenges, and time commitments are monumental. We learned that only 2.5% of all the boys that enter Scouting achieve the rank Eagle Scout. Throughout history, the Eagle has symbolized man's best and highest achievements. In the year 1911, the Boy Scouts of America chose the Eagle to symbolize Scouting's best and highest rank of advancement. Tonight, we're here to recognize and pay honor to Matthew Warner, Cliff Bunot, and Cody Rich. Their parents and leaders have labored long and faithfully through the Scouting program. Their efforts are rewarded here tonight in the presentation of the Eagle Badge.
Well, I was going to start out tonight by saying I'm glad to be here, but there's too many people here to say that. For those of you who don't know me, I was a scoutmaster of Troop 474 for quite a few years, and I was lucky enough to be the scoutmaster when these three young men come into the troop. And they wanted me to get up here tonight and share some of my memories and some of the experiences that I've had with them. And I'd like to do that, and I'd like to have each one of them come up as I talked about them, because they're better looking than me, so I figured you'd like to see them better than me. So if we could, I'd like to start with Cody Rich and have him come up. One of the first things that I remember about Cody was our very first overnighter. Cody went with us. And I don't remember where we went, what we were doing, or anything else, but I remember we got up that morning, we were making breakfast. And we were having breakfast burritos. Cody was standing there. He was watching them being made. And in breakfast burritos, we put sausage, scrambled eggs, and chopped up onions and peppers. Cody, he came up to me, and he told me in no way, shape, or form did he like onions or peppers, and he would not eat it. I thought to myself, great, there's another kid who won't eat anything, who's going to get sick, and then I'm going to have to bring him home sick every camp out. Now, I noticed Cody, though, he got one and he ate it. I don't know if he liked it or not, did you? But I think he figured out there wasn't anything else to eat. So he ate it. But I've had Cody do the sand dunes with us and everything else, and everything I cook, I put onions and peppers in. Cody has always ate it from then on and never complained. So I have him a little gift tonight I'd like to give him. Got him a Dutch oven cookbook so that he can cook his own now from now on. Stay here. There's one other thing that I want to say about Cody. I don't know if he remembers this or not, but when he first came into the troop, I think he was 12, and the senior patrol leader was always in charge of the troop, and we always liked to play games and things like that at the first, kind of get the boys wore down a little bit, so they'd sit down and listen for 5 minutes to something. And this one particular meeting, and I know Cody hadn't been in the troop for 2 or 3 months, and the senior patrol leader wasn't there, and I asked, who wants to be in charge? Cody, he raises his hand and wants to be in charge. So I says, okay, Cody, it's you. And the very first thing that happened, I says, Cody, we need a game to play or something for a few minutes, so what are we going to do? He turned around to every boy there and says, okay, you guys, what do you want to do? At that point right there, I knew that Cody had leadership skills. And he has always shown leadership skills throughout his scouting career while I have been with him, and I'm very proud of him for that. And also, on all our week trips and things, I make videos and stuff like that, so I have a video of the week trips that I'd like to present Cody at this time too. If I can find yours. There you go. Congratulations. Thank you. We'll have Matt come up next. Matt was always the cleanest scout I ever had. I think this was because his dad was always with us on most of the campouts and everything. But this one time in particular, Tamarack Lake, Matt was washing his hair, and his dad was there, and he happened to have his camp stove. He was heating water for him. Now, you know, most scouts, so if they're in the high UNAs and they go on to wash their hair, they just go soak their head in the lake for a minute, which most of them won't anyway, but Matt, he was getting his hair washed. And you know, when you're testing water to see how hot it is with your fingers, you can take a little hotter water than you can on something sensitive like the back of your neck. Well, Vern was testing the water, and it happened that he was ready to get rinsed off, and Vern started to dump it on his head, and Matt started to scream and started to swing at him and everything else. And I've got that all on tape, too, so they can watch that anytime they want to watch it. But because of that, I've got Matt a little something. Got him a bottle of shampoo so he can wash his own hair from now on. Matt, he also always had good leadership skills. And I've got a list from his dad of the things that he did in the troop. When he was under me, he was a patrol leader, and he did a very fine job of that. He always would call everybody in his patrol and tell them about the scout meetings and everything, and he always had the best run patrol when I was a scoutmaster. But besides patrol leader, he was also a quartermaster, a troop scribe, an assistant senior patrol leader, and the senior patrol leader. You know, and a boy does not have that many leadership positions if he doesn't have leadership skills. And Matt is one of the best scouts for having leadership skills that I have ever seen, and I'm very proud of him for that. I also have a video to give Matt. Congratulations on getting an eagle. You bet. Now we'll have Face come up. Face is his nickname, and so I'm going to slip and call him that. Face was always the dirtiest scout I ever had. And I think that's because his dad was there most of the time. But I didn't really have to worry about him. I knew what he could handle and what he couldn't handle and things like that. So I was worried about the other boys that I didn't know as well most of the time. But I have pictures of him sitting in the campfire after it's been put out, and you know how black that is. I have pictures of him covered with mud. It just, no matter where he was dirty, and I don't know why. But I have a little present for him for that. Got him a bar of lava soap so he can keep clean, I hope. There was one other thing about Faye, though. He impressed me one time really, really good as a father and a scoutmaster. I used to always go to the round tables, and at one of these round tables, they announced that they wanted to have anybody who wanted to design and draw patches for our camperees. Every time we'd go on a camperee, you'd get a patch. So I took this information back to the troop and let everybody know, and Face, he went home and got busy on one. And his was the only one that I turned in from our troop. And I didn't think nothing else of it. I'd forgotten all about it. And about 6 months later, we went on a... We went on a camperee out at Antelope Island, and they had used his patch, his design to make that patch. And I think it's still one of the best ones I've ever got. But I'm proud of him for that. I have a thought I'd like to leave to these guys tonight. For anybody who's ever been an Eagle Scout or a Scout, I want you to think back to the time when you first thought about ever becoming an Eagle Scout. He was probably about 11 or 12 years old. And there was probably a lot of other young men your same age is thinking about becoming Eagle Scouts at that time. But these other young men who didn't achieve this rank, they probably didn't consider the hard work or they didn't think they had the time, or they thought they had better things to do with their time, but whatever it was, they didn't plan and they didn't set the goals to be where you three are tonight. Your mind's a marvelous thing that your Father in Heaven's given you, and it can have up to 400 thoughts a minute. And it's up to you guys whether these thoughts are positive or negative. And I know that you three have positive thoughts. All three of you have been senior patrol leader of Troop 474, and all three of you have been doing the things that you should be doing to attain the rank of Eagle. But you need to use the tools that you've used now to become Eagle Scouts, and you need to use them into becoming a better man in your thoughts and actions always, and always make your thoughts positive. Being a scoutmaster is the neatest thing in the world. You get to see all these kids coming into your troop at 11 years old, and every one of them wants to do everything that they can do in scouting the first week. But after the first few months, they start weeding out, and you get the cream of the crop that sticks with you and becomes Eagle Scouts. And I'm very proud of you three for doing that. All three of you have been friends all through scouts. To me, you're the three musketeers. You're always doing everything together. There was, in closing, I'd just like to say that one time there was a wise king, and he says that when you're in the service of others, you're in the service of your God. And if there's one thing that I want you guys to take out of scouting with you, it's to do your duty to God, and that comes out of the scout oath. Because if you think about it for a minute, if you're doing your duty to God, you're living the scout oath, the scout law, the scout slogan, and the scout motto. I'd like to thank the scouts, and I'd like to thank the parents of the scouts tonight for letting me be part of their lives and for letting me grow with them. And I say this in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Between the innocence of babyhood and the dignity of manhood, we find a delightful creature called a scout. Scouts come in assorted sizes, shapes, weights, and colors, but all scouts have the same creed. Only on my honor, I will do my best to make every scout meeting as noisy and exciting, as much fun as possible. To do my duty to harass the scoutmaster and troop committee. To obey and listen as little as possible. To help other people have as much fun on hikes and campouts, swimming parties, ball games, and outings as I do. To keep myself mentally awake by watching matching wits with the forest ranger, by outthinking the lifeguard, frustrating the school teachers, and mystifying my parents. And morally straight by shocking everyone by sitting reverently in church. This is not quite how the official one reads, but it is much more interesting and fun and accurate. A scout has the energy of a bull moose, the agility of a swallow, the alertness of a night owl, the lungs of a bullfrog, the endurance of a tortoise, the appetite of a horse, the audacity of a magpie, the voice of a screech owl, and the heart of a dove. A scout is a magical creature which denies the accurate description or understanding, but without which our future would be in doubt, and without which there would be an empty void in the hearts of many parents and scoutmasters. Even more unique and special than this is a small species within the group, curiously called the eagle, an order of a young man who finds himself conspicuously between boyhood and manhood, knowing, understanding, and living the moral code of honor of adulthood, yet still firmly grasping the vitality and abundance of youth. This group is a seldom found minority in the race of man, who has not yet been dimmed by the disillusion and discouragement of maturity, who has not been tainted or tempted by the corrupt rewards of rancid world. Here is an order of young men who hold not only the hope and optimism of youth, but also the ability and the talent of old, not only the innocence of boyhood, but the strength and power of manhood, not only the firmness and wisdom of ages, but also the humor and fun-loving spirit of youth. Here then is a truly unique special order, the Order of the Eagle Scout. We welcome tonight the select Eagle Scout candidates, Matt Warner, Cliff Bunot, and Cody Rich. It has just been a few years since first entered the troop. Your mother taught you so young, but 11 was the perfect age to join the older boys in your scouting career. As you became a member of the troop, you memorized the scout oath and law, its principles and symbols. You learned the care of importance of your nation's flag and mastered certain basic tying techniques and became a tenderfoot scout. You immediately went on to learn the skills of the second class scout. You studied the art of techniques of hiking and outdoor activities. You took a hike. You learned to master a compass and orient map to prepare you for an emergency and living in the wilderness. You learned various plants and animals, the correct and safe use of knife and axe. You learned to cook a full course meal using no utensils over an open fire, only 2 matches. And you were not allowed to forget your duties learned under the tenderfoot, testing as you continue to render good turns and live by the scout principles. As you gained the first class rank, you were singled out from the other boys. As the testing and trials became more rigorous, you mastered the techniques of outdoor camping. As you carefully planned, organized, and executed 2 24-hour campouts, including food, shelter, and cleanup. You learned safe swimming practices, including a 50-yard swim, advanced first aid, knot tying, and lashing, and service hours. Soon you found yourself at the halfway mark on the way to an Eagle Scout, and yet the hardest tasks were still ahead of you. To obtain the star rank, you earned 6 merit badges, which meant in-depth study, training, and performance in select fields. In each of these subjects, you had to master certain advancements, techniques, and ideas. But you were also held accountable for service projects as well as serving as an officer in the scouting program. Next came the Eagle, the rank of Life Scout. And within stiffer and more difficult requirements, you earned the 5 additional merit badges and a series service project, filling a job in troop and office for passing the custom board of review. Now came the final and most difficult effort in achieving the rank of an Eagle. A total of 21 merit badges or more were mastered and passed, as well as planning, developing, and carrying out a service project, fulfilling a troop leadership position in the troop, and passing a final board of review before a district representative. Now let us find out what happens to the Eagle Scouts. For every 100 boys join scouting, records indicate rarely will one be brought before a juvenile court system. 2 will become Eagle Scouts in the LDS Church. 5. 17 will become future scouting volunteers. 12 will have the first contact with the church through scouting. 1 will enter the clergy. 5 will earn their church religious awards. 18 will develop hobbies that will last throughout their life. 8 will enter a vocation that was learned through merit badge programs. 1 will use the scouting skill to save his own life. 1 will use the scouting skills to save another person's life. Tonight, we honor 3 more boys. We know the things that they have done in the past. Imagine what they will do, these great young men will do in the future.
apologize for not announcing Scott Jorgensen's name for the narrator. He's done a real good job with that. Some good videos. From this point, we'll go ahead and do the Eagle Oath by Dennis City. And then after that, we'll have a presentation of the Eagle Badges by Dennis City. And then we'll have an Eagle's Prayer, which will be narrated by John Boatwright. And we'll go to that point.
Would the Eagle Escorts please bring the Eagles forward? Courts are dismissed and we'll usually gather a few minutes. By the authority invested in me by the National Court of Honor of the Boy Scouts of America, it's my privilege and pleasure to pronounce upon you the Eagle Oath. May the oath I'm about to give you always remain with you. I need you to make the scout sign and then repeat after me.
I.
Now one at a time, state your name.
Matthew Warner.
Cody Ridge,
Cliff Bunot.
Okay, all together now. Realize the obligations.
Realize the obligations.
To my fellow Eagles.
To my fellow Eagles.
My home.
My home.
My country.
My country.
And my God.
And my God.
I will at all times do my best. To assist other scouts.
To assist other scouts.
Who are climbing the trail to Eagle.
Who are climbing the trail to Eagle.
And to give back more to scouting.
Give back more to scouting.
Than it has given to me.
Than it has given to me.
To assist my troop.
Assist my troop
as much as possible.
As much as possible.
And be a living example. To the scout oath and law. To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
This time with the Eagle Escorts, please bring the parents forward.
An Eagle's Prayer. Now that I'm an Eagle Scout, looking back at the trail that I've trod, I see why scouting is important to me, and so I offer this humble prayer. For I know I couldn't have gone this far without help from others who serve as my star. So thank you, Lord, for my chance to be a patriot in the land of the free. Thank you for homes, churches, and schools. Thank you for parents, teachers, and rules. Thank you for leaders who understand they always stand ready to give me their hand. Let me share my gifts wherever I go, for I must try to repay the debt that I owe. Let me treat everyone as a sister or brother and reward each good turn by doing another. Help me fight through weary and scared. Let me meet every crisis by being prepared. Give me the will to do my best, to do my duty and pass life's test. Grant me the wisdom, honor, and courage to do all the things that are pleasing to you. Remind me, if I ever stray, that other eagles have paved the right way. Their spirits are watching and waiting to see that I do all that's expected of me. If I should fall towards the ground, put forth your arm so I won't let them down. With your fingers tipped with like fire, upon my heart you will write your will and purpose to help me climb higher. I promise to strive for a worthy goal that I know will be solid and right. Lift up my wings and nourish my soul. As I dare the eagle's flight, chart me a course that's straight and true, using the scout oath and law as my guide. Teach my mind, body, and heart what to do so you can smile upon me with pride. Keep me sharp like a knife to cut through all the darkness and doubt. Let me never forget as I soar through life that I am an Eagle Scout.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time I'd like to present to you Lakeview District's newest Eagle Scouts.
I guess why we have them captured up here on the stage. We have several other presentations to do at this time. And we'll start out with a presentation of the neckerchiefs, which will be done by Bishop Howard Eastland. And then we will have another presentation by Roy West Stake President, which will be done by Alan Karras. We'll go to that point and then we'll do the rest.
Those places, but it's an honor to be here tonight and present this, so we'll do that now. Thank you.
On behalf of the state presidency, we'd like to give these young men a letter of congratulations. Also, as it's been in our state's tradition, as that we would give each young man, we call them silver dollars, but there's no silver in them, but two silver dollars. One is to keep for themselves to remember this occasion. The other one is for them to pass on to their son when they earn their rank of Eagle. So I'd like to present them at this time.
If you got to see the backs of these or not, but while I'm turning around and let you see the backs of them, there are some really neat neckerchiefs they have. Okay, you can turn around. Okay, we have a few more presentations. The next one we'll do these in order. The next ones we'll have is from the veterans of foreign wars, and that'll be done by Robert Jurek. And then the next one will be the American Legion, which will be done by Commander Dick Van Leer. Then after that, we'll have one from the Golden Spike Eagle Elk Lodge, and it'll be done by Claudia J. Nixon. And then after those, we'll have a presentation that Face and Cody has to do, and we'll go to that point now.
Good evening. This is a very special occasion, and with three young men who've attained the rank of Eagle Scout. And to help me with the presentation, I've asked members of the Veterans of Foreign Wars and also members of the American Legion to join me. We have the commander of the Veterans of Foreign Wars, Sarah Hassong, is here. She also is the commander of the American Legion, Post 139, so she's filling a dual role tonight. As I mentioned, this is a very special occasion, not only for Matthew, Cody, and Cliff, but for each of us. And I hope that each one of us will remember this as long as you live. You know, it's fitting that the Eagle Scout emblem is red, white, and blue, because we pay a special tribute to the red, white, and blue, the Stars and Stripes emblem. It's a special emblem that Congress in 1777 adopted as the official flag of the United States. Another thing that makes this a special occasion is the fact that Post 8868 of the Veterans of Foreign Wars and American Legion Post 139 are presenting an American flag to each of these Eagle Scouts. Now, this is a flag that has flown over the capital of our country. And the flag of our country is very important to the veterans of our country. We want it to be very important to you. More than a million men and women of my veterans organizations have fought under the Stars and Stripes flag. They have served in the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, the Marine Corps, and the Coast Guard. They fought against the enemies in the World War I, World War II, Vietnam, Korea, the Persian Gulf, and others. And these flags to these boys. We're proud of it. We want you to be proud of it. And so on behalf of the Veterans of Foreign Wars and the American Legion, we present each of you a flag of our country, one that has flown over the capital of the United States. If you would present this. Now, to accompany each of these flags, there is a certificate, and I'll read from it. This is to certify that the accompanying flag was flown over the United States Capitol on, and it gives a date. This flag was flown on behalf of the American Legion and the Veterans of Foreign Wars. It was flown for, and each one is individualized for the boys, on the occasion of becoming an Eagle Scout and was presented by the Veterans of Foreign Wars, Post 8868 of Hill Air Force Base, and the American Legion Post 139 of Riverdale.
I'm representing all the veterans. Veterans of Foreign Wars, veterans who did not have to go overseas in combat, but we're serving all those who have served this country with heart and soul, with a purpose. The younger generation, World War I, World War II, and even the Korean War is history to them. Many of them do not understand the sacrifices that has been made for this great land, for this great land is the greatest land on the face of this earth. My comrades in arms and myself, we have seen many countries. We have had many experiences. And we can testify to you that this is the greatest land above all land. And it will be so if we just serve God and this country. That this was great honor that Matthew, Cliff, and Cody are recognized as a great accomplishment to be an Eagle Scout. Dame Warner, the American Legion, Certificate of Participation, Matt Warner, Boy Scout Troop 474 Roy, Utah, is awarded this certificate in appreciation of and recognition for active participation in all Scouts requirements attaining to the rank of Eagle Scouts. Presented by the American Legion Post 134 Clearfield, Utah, this fourth day of October 1998 at Roy, Utah. Signed and attached by my adjutant, Dale Manley, and signed Dirk Van Leer, Commander.
Only about 2 out of 100 Scouts ever achieve this rank of Eagle Scouting. That makes you three young men very special. You're the cream of the crop. And I am particularly pleased that the Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks has commissioned me to present to you a token in appreciation of your achievement. We chose the American flag for it is synonymous with the Eagle. When you entered into the realm of scouting, you were eager for the wonderful fellowship and tremendous teachings of an organization devoted to building personal integrity through democratic methods. You have attained the honor of Eagle Scout, not only by mastering a multitude of skills, but also by understanding, accepting, and practicing the teachings of our country. The Order of Elks is distinctively American, linking the destiny of our order with the destiny of our country. We have made its flag the symbol of the crowning virtue. And now, sirs, regard that flag. The beauty of its silken folds reminds us always of the proud history of our country. It nourishes in the hearts of all reverence for what it represents and the memory of those who offered their lives in its defense. The gentle breezes with lingering caress kiss the folds of no flag that can compare with it in beauty. There's no such red in budding rose, in falling leaf, or sparkling wine. No such white in April blossom, in crescent moon, or mountain snow. No such blue in woman's eye, in ocean's depth, or heaven's dome. and no such pageantry of clustering stars and streaming light in all the spectrum of the sea and sky. And on behalf of the Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks of the United States of America, I present you with this, our flag.
This time last year he could have had his eagle, but he showed true friendship to me and Cliff by waiting for us, and we got him a little something for that. It's a Leatherman.
Surprising. Need you all to make the scout sign and repeat after me. I reaffirm my allegiance.
I reaffirm my allegiance.
To the three promises of the scout oath.
To the three promises of the scout oath.
I thoughtfully recognize.
I thoughtfully recognize.
And take upon myself.
And take upon myself.
The obligations and responsibilities.
The obligations and responsibilities.
Of the rank of Eagle Scout.
Of the rank of Eagle Scout.
On my honor.
On my honor,
I will do my best.
I will do my best
to make my training an example.
To make my training an example.
My rank and my influence.
My rank and my influence
count strongly for better scouting.
Count strongly for better scouting.
And for better citizenship.
And for better citizenship.
In my unit.
In my unit.
And in my community.
And in my community.
And in my contact with other people.
And in my contact with other people.
To this I pledge my sacred honor.
To this I pledge my sacred honor.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Really enjoyed the efforts of the people that's taken part of the program, and I'm sure they appreciate everybody that's come here and supported them in getting their eagle tonight. So we'd like to give you a big thanks for being here. We'll have the benediction. It will be given by Corey Butterfield. And then afterwards, we have some refreshments and stuff. And because these boys had me come up here and do this tonight, they kind of got me out of doing the cooking. So if it's not right, it's the other two guys that's out there cooking, not me. So after the benediction, then we'll go ahead and serve the refreshments over in the kitchen here.
Our dear Father, which art in heaven, we come before thee this time in humble thanks for the opportunity that we've all had to come here tonight in honoring Cody, Cliff, and Matt in their getting the Eagle Scout. We ask a special blessing upon them, Lord, that they will take this evening into their lives and the training that which they have received in becoming eagles and use it in their daily lives, and that they can become better citizens of this great nation which thou hast set apart for the choice people to live in. We ask thee to please bless the refreshments that has been prepared, that they might nourish and strengthen our bodies and do them which the good which they need. Please bless the people which have traveled far and not so far, that they will be kept safe from harm or accident on their way home. And please bless that we can always strive to be better citizens and members of the church and just better people in general. We pray for these things humbly, Lord, in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.